हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट। मैडम इसको मिरर व्यू पे जाओ, उल्टा आ रहा है ना। यहाँ
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
से देखना, यहाँ से। हाँ, मिरर व्यू आ रहा नहीं आ रहा, दूसरा देखो। हाँ, वीडियो मिरर आप करें। अब फिर अभी नहीं उल्टा हुआ, फिर हुआ। मिरर व्यू इसी को दबाओ, मिरर वीडियो मिरर। हेलो स्टूडेंट, गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड
गुड
मॉर्निंग
मॉर्निंग
सर। गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
हेलो ज्योत्सना कोहली,
यस सर, अब आई
आर यू
आवाज।
प्रेजेंट?
यस सर।
एम आई ऑडिबल और नॉट?
यस सर, अब आई आवाज।
टेल समथिंग। विवेक पचौरी, यू ऑन योर कैमरा? ऑडिबल? ओके। ध्वनि तिल्लानी, ज्योत्सना कोहली, नाउ ऑडिबल? ओके। तो गिव योर अटेंडेंस। है अदिति, हैज कम और नॉट? दर्शना माली, ज्योत्सना कोहली, इशिता भटनागर, भविष्य ढाका, विवेक पचौरी, आस्था द्विवेदी, लक्षिता धाकर। गिव रेस्पॉन्स वेदर यू आर लिसनिंग मी और नॉट।
यस सर।
यू आर राइटिंग बट यू कैन नॉट स्पीक। यू कैन स्पीक, यू कैन टेल योर अटेंडेंस यस सर लाइक दिस विद साउंड। यू ऑन योर कैमरा
प्रेजेंट
एंड माइक।
सर। प्रेजेंट सर।
यस,
प्रेजेंट सर।
वाज अनिकेत माझी? तो
यस सर। प्रेजेंट सर।
वॉइस
प्रेजेंट
इज
सर।
नॉट क्लियर।
सर प्रेजेंट।
हमारा क्लियर नहीं, हमारा स्पीकर ऑफ है ना भाई? हेलो स्टूडेंट, ज्योत्सना कोहली,
यस सर।
एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस सर।
दर्शना माली, आर
यस सर।
यू लिसनिंग मी और नॉट?
दे आर लिसनिंग,
आई एम
हमारा
लिसनिंग।
वॉइस नहीं आ रही है सर। आप देखो, अच्छा सॉल्व दिस।
नाउ इट इज कमिंग। एवरीथिंग इज ऑन माइक्रोफोन। अब आया, नाउ यू आर लिसनिंग मी?
यस सर।
यस
यस सर।
हेलो हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर। गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड
आर
मॉर्निंग सर।
आई वांट टू
गुड
नो
मॉर्निंग।
वेदर यू आर लिसनिंग मी और नॉट। ज्योत्सना कोहली, राजीव यादव। सो टुडे आई विल टीच यू प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ हेलो एल्केन। एंड यस्टरडे आई टॉट यू प्रिपरेशन ऑफ हेलो एल्केन एंड हेलो एरीन। नो टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ हेलो एल्केन एंड हेलो एरीन। फर्स्ट फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज। अमंग फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज वी कंसिडर फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज, नंबर वन बॉइलिंग पॉइंट। सो फर्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग अबाउट द बॉइलिंग पॉइंट ऑफ हेलो एल्केन, दैट इज द बॉइलिंग पॉइंट ऑफ हेलो एल्केन इज हायर देन हाइड्रोकार्बन, बिकॉज if we consider a hydrocarbon like methane and if we consider haloalkane like CH3Cl, then the molecular mass of haloalkane is more than hydrocarbon. So this is a simple principle: as the molecular mass increases, boiling point increases, correct? So haloalkane has higher boiling point than corresponding hydrocarbon, the one important thing. Second, if we consider haloalkane of same alkyl group, means this alkyl group is same, like CH3Cl, CH3F, CH3Br, CH3I, then from fluoride to iodide, if alkyl group is same, boiling point increases. This you can take by example. Like CH3F boiling point 195 Kelvin, CH chloro methane CH3Cl boiling point 249 Kelvin, and bromo methane boiling point 278 Kelvin, and iodo methane boiling point 316 Kelvin. So you can understand that the boiling point increases as the molecular mass of corresponding halogen increases. Means from fluoride to iodide, boiling point increases as their molecular mass increases. So, but if you change the R group and you take same halogen, correct? You change the R group. For example, you take CH3Cl, then C2H5Cl, then C3H7Cl, C4H9Cl. Here halogen is same, but we have changed the alkyl group: methyl, ethyl, propyl, butyl. So as the size of alkyl group increases, boiling point increases. Like the CH3Cl 249, C2H5Cl 251, it is around 251, sorry, it is 285. C3H7Cl, मतलब क्लोरोप्रोपेन, इट्स बॉइलिंग पॉइंट 320, एंड ब्यूटे क्लोरोब्यूटेन इट्स बॉइलिंग पॉइंट 351. सो नाउ यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड, एज यू इंक्रीज द साइज ऑफ एल्किल ग्रुप, बॉइलिंग पॉइंट इंक्रीजेज. as you increase the size of alkyl group, boiling point increases. So these two important concepts you have to keep in your mind, that as the size of alkyl group increases, boiling point increases, because on increasing the size, atomic mass increases, molecular mass increases, correct? Here in this case, in case of halogen, from fluoride to iodide, atomic mass increases, fluorine ka 19 hota hai, chlorine ka 35.5 hota hai, so it is increases, correct? So as the molecular mass, atomic mass increases, so molecular mass will also increase, that's why boiling point increases. Now we discuss about the melting point. Melting point, if we consider the melting point depends upon the packing of molecule in solid state. What is the concept behind the melting point? Because melting point is taking the temperature at which a solid melt, correct? So when you are consider a solid, then in case of solid, how the molecules of a solid get packed? How the molecules of a solid get packed, correct? So packing, now you can see in this case of methyl chloride, methyl bromide, methyl iodide, these are gases. Even ethyl chloride is also gases. So as we increase, the molecular mass increases, size of alkyl group increases, their atomic mass increases, so they are changing their physical state from gaseous state to liquid state. Gaseous state to liquid state. Then if we go very high range of molecular mass or large size, like chloropentane, hexane, is range mein jayenge, then it becomes solid. So we consider a solid by taking a simple example. Say you take haloarene, chlorobenzene, correct, and dichlorobenzene, 1,2 dichlorobenzene. One, three dichlorobenzene. One, four dichlorobenzene. So another name you can give it, because this second chlorine is at ortho position. It is ortho dichlorobenzene. Para, meta dichlorobenzene, para dichlorobenzene, correct? So now you consider almost their molecular mass is same, correct? So their boiling point will not change, boiling point is almost same. But if you consider their, this is a fine, for example, you consider their boiling point, you take the boiling point of orthochlorobenzene at 453 Kelvin. It is sub, it all, unit is only Kelvin, and for metachlorobenzene 446 Kelvin, for parachlorobenzene 448. So this 453, 446, 448, it is almost same, it is comparable, 2-3 Kelvin ka difference hai, correct? The 246, 248 only 2 Kelvin, 248 and 253 only 5 Kelvin difference. So it is, you can say it is almost same boiling point. But if we consider melting point, orthochlorobenzene ka melting point 256, metachlorobenzene ka 249, and parachlorobenzene ka 323 Kelvin. So now if we consider parachlorobenzene from metachlorobenzene, how much difference? It is approximately 74 Kelvin difference. 74, difference is 74, and from 256, it is almost 70, 65 Kelvin difference. So it is a large difference, you can say. Now, because the difference is large, we consider why the melting points increases in case of para. एंड व्हाट इज डिक्रीज इन केस ऑफ मेटा करेक्ट और पैरा बिकॉज इफ वी सी द शेप ऑफ पैरा डाइक्लोरोबेंजीन इट इज सिमेट्रिकल यू कैन सी इट इज सिमेट्रिकल सो इन केस ऑफ सिमेट्रिकल मॉलिक्यूल विल पैक इन सॉलिड स्टेट वेरी क्लोजली अभी जस्ट रिंकू मैडम एक्सप्लेन यू सॉलिड स्टेट एंड पैकिंग ऑफ द पार्टिकल्स इन सॉलिड स्टेट इफ द पैकिंग ऑफ द पार्टिकल सॉलिड स्टेट वेरी क्लोजली पैक्ड देन दे हैव वेरी हाई मेल्टिंग पॉइंट बिकॉज इट पैकिंग इज वेरी क्लोज देन देयर अट्रैक्शन इज वेरी हाई एंड इफ यू हैव हाई अट्रैक्शन इट मीन्स दे हैव हाई melting point that's why in case of para chlorobenzene melting point is high so you can this question may be asked in the board examination why if we consider the melting point of metachlorobenzene and para chlorobenzene metachlorobenzene so why para chlorobenzene has higher boiling point 323 while metachlorobenzene has 249 explain so the explanation is para chlorobenzene is symmetrical in nature parachlorobenzene is symmetrical in nature so due to symmetry in the molecule they have close packing and due to close packing the attraction between the molecule is very high that's why they have a strong force of attraction so they have high melting point correct now the next property is physical property that is solubility solubility if we see the solubility from the I think class 11th also even class 10th also teachers had explained you solubility of any chemical compound depends on a term like dissolves like ek proverb hai like dissolves like what is the meaning of this proverb like dissolves like if we consider a polar solvent and the molecule is also polar then they get dissolved so like dissolved like means polar molecule dissolve in polar solvent non polar molecule dissolve in non polar solvent correct so in case of haloalkane if we consider chloromethane correct so this chloromethane this carbon on chlorine bond is polar bond correct because they have high polarity chlorine is highly electronegative so this will partial negative charge this will partial positive charge due to partial positive charge over the carbon atom and negative charge on chlorine atom if we consider water molecule oxygen has negative charge and hydrogen has positive charge water is also polar so both are polar molecule it means both should be soluble but actually haloalkanes are less soluble in water so now the question is this why haloalkanes are less soluble so it is a very typical situation ke haloalkanes are less soluble in water why because though they are polar question poochte hain board exam mein 2-3 times this question has been asked haloalkanes though haloalkanes are polar in nature still their solubility is very less why so ye proverb kehna hai ki like dissolves like yahan pe fit nahi ho raha hai correct so because there is some special reason behind it now I will explain you though haloalkanes are polar in nature still they are less soluble in water because due to polarity in haloalkane these haloalkane molecules are bonded among themselves through hydrogen bonding and the bond between haloalkane is stronger than the bond present in the water molecules dusri baat if they want to associate with the water molecule then these haloalkane molecule should first break their bond and the energy required to break the bond among the haloalkane molecule is more then the energy released during the bond form between haloalkane molecule and water molecule. Correct? So, when the energy required is more than the energy released, then the solubility decreases. This is the funda here. Very important principle, because we can simply say like dissolves like. But like dissolves like ka basic themes kya hai? Basic themes here, when a compound gets dissolved in water molecule or any solvent, then it forms bond with the water molecule. And before it forms bond with the water molecule, it also first break the bond exist between them. To if they want to break the bond exist earlier, then some energy required to break the bond. If the energy required to break the bond is less than the energy released, then its solubility will be more. But if the energy required is more than the energy released, then solubility will be less. Correct? So this is the basic thing behind this. Now in this case, you can say haloalkane is less soluble in water molecule, though they are polar, because the bonding exists among the haloalkane is strong. So energy required to break the bond between haloalkane molecule need more energy than the energy released during the formation of bond with haloalkane and water molecule. That's why they are less soluble. So this is about the physical properties of haloalkane. Now I will discuss with you chemical properties of haloalkane and haloarene. You give your attendance properly, or you say if you have joined. Till now only 29 student attended the class. Where about the other student? I think 13 students are missing. So Aastha Dubedi, agar if some new students come, they give your attendance by saying either on a speaker or you on your web camera so that I can see you. Correct? So now you can see the 29 se 30 hoga student. 30 student has joined. So yesterday there were 36 student attend the class. Because this Google Meet classes started to increase your attendance, you have to attend the class sincerely, regularly. That's why you can understand. Correct? That's why our principal sir started this Google Meet class, so we can see your attendance properly. And even you can, if you have any doubt, you can speak and ask your doubt, and you can come with your camera. You make arrangement so that you can, I can see you if you ask any question. Correct? So that we can enjoy this Google Meet class more effectively as compared to the YouTube classes. So first you give your attendance properly. Still the number of students showing here 30. Correct? So now I will go to the chemical properties of haloalkane. You write here chemical properties. If we consider the chemical properties of haloalkane, we divide the chemical properties of haloalkane into three type of reaction. Number one, nucleophilic substitution reaction. Isko short mein le sakte hain, NSR. Nucleophilic substitution reaction. Second, elimination reaction. Elimination reaction. Third, reaction with metals. So these three type of reaction we can categorize in concern with the haloalkane or haloarene. So now first we discuss nucleophilic substitution reaction. Yesterday I told you about the electrophilic substitution reaction. And in class 11th, this is very important topic, hydrocarbon and basic concept of chemistry. In that topic you study about the different types of reaction. And in these different type of reaction, nucleophilic substitution reaction, electrophilic substitution reaction, a teacher explain you. Correct? So, first I will discuss nucleophilic substitution reaction. So, first to write the definition of nucleophilic substitution reaction. Correct? So, what is the definition of nucleophilic substitution reaction? To write a substitution reaction, likhiye, a substitution reaction in which substitution takes place by an attack of nucleophile. By an attack of nucleophile. एक डेफिनेशन तो ये बन जाती है. दूसरा डेफिनेशन, अ सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन इन विच सब्स्टिट्यूशन टेक प्लेस थ्रू न्यूक्लियोफाइल. इसी तरीके का हम डिफाइन करना चाहें इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन, तो सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन इन विच सब्स्टिट्यूशन टेक प्लेस बाय इलेक्ट्रोफाइल. करेक्ट? तो डेफिनेशन वेरी सिंपल. करेक्ट? तो अब नाउ वी कंसिडर वॉट इज न्यूक्लियोफाइल. एनीवन ऑफ यू कैन टेल वॉट इज न्यूक्लियोफाइल? I want to know what is nucleophile. You can tell. Speak loudly.
Electron rich species.
Yes, very good. And some others, you tell what is nucleophile. Some student, please speak. Jyotsna Kohli, you speak. What is nucleophile?
Electron rich species which donates electron pairs.
Yes, very good. That's why I want to know. You give your interaction, you give your question answer so that we can interact you with more effectively. So just now Jyotsna also told. Now I will ask from Bhavish Dhaka, what is nucleophile? Bhavish?
Electron rich species which donate electrons.
बस ये donate word लगाने की जरूरत नहीं है. न्यूक्लियोफाइल की डेफिनेशन में यू कैन इट इज सिंपली इलेक्ट्रॉन रिच स्पीसीज. करेक्ट? डोनेट करने के लिए जरूरी नहीं है. जब इलेक्ट्रॉन रिच होता है तो डोनेट तो करेगा ही, जरूरत पड़ेगी तब. करेक्ट? लेकिन अगर हम लिगेंड के केस में जाते हैं तो फिर हमें डोनेट करना जाना पड़ता है कि डोनेट करेगा वो, क्योंकि वहां पर डोनेशन बहुत रिक्वायर्ड है. यहाँ पर नहीं, अटैक करते हैं. तो न्यूक्लियोफाइल और इलेक्ट्रॉन रिच स्पीसीज. करेक्ट? इसीलिए आपने देखा होगा 11th क्लास में टीचर ने बताया होगा कि न्यूक्लियोफाइल्स आर लुईस बेस. लुईस बेस भी इलेक्ट्रॉन रिच स्पीसीज होते हैं. करेक्ट? सो नाउ यू नो अबाउट इट व्हाट इज न्यूक्लियोफाइल. नाउ आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू. यू कंसीडर दिस हैलो एल्केन, लेट इट बी Cl. करेक्ट? दिस दीस थ्री बॉन्ड, सपोज इफ यू कंसीडर एनी जनरल हैलो एल्केन देन RHH. Correct? So R may be any alkyl group, CH3 suppose it is, then CH2R. Now among this, as you know that this carbon atom is sp3 hybridized. So how these four bonds are bonded? These four bonds are bonded by tetrahedrally. So iska tetrahedral structure aana chahiye. Correct? Aisa karke. Theek hai na? Ab ye tetrahedral dikh raha hoga aapko. This is tetrahedral structure. Correct? Now if a nucleophile attack, let it be, we can simply write nucleophile which is electron rich species. A nucleophile which is electron rich species, so I put two dot. Now if we consider this carbon chlorine bond, then you know that chlorine is electronegative, so the bond pair electron of this bond slightly attract towards the chlorine, so chlorine will get partial negative charge and carbon will get partial positive charge. Correct? Now this nucleophile, because it is electron rich species, so it will attack on the partial positive charge carbon, so it will attack over here. Correct? Now how it will attack, I will show you. I will attack you like this. It will attack like this. Correct? Now question arises, why it attack from the back side? Why attack from the back side? Why attack from the back side? Because from this side, this is chlorine which is negatively charged, and it is also electron rich species. So electron rich species cannot attack through the electronegative species. It will attack through to the partial positively charged species. That's why it attack over the carbon, and to attack through the carbon, it have to attack from the back side. So it attack from the back side. Correct. Now when it attack from the back side, now you can see how many bond of the carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But 4 bond is not possible. So now nucleophile attack over the carbon. This bond formation takes place. Then this bond breaking start. So this start to break. This start to form. एक बहुत सिंपल रूल है कि जब नए बॉन्ड बनते हैं तो पुराने बॉन्ड टूटते हैं. एक नए बॉन्ड बनते हैं. आप देखो अपने लाइफ में भी देखो. आप लाइफ में क्या होता है कि अभी आपकी बॉन्डिंग किसके साथ है? अपने मम्मी पापा के साथ है. आपकी एक फैमिली है जिसमें मम्मी है, पापा है, भाई है, बहन है, उनसे आपकी बॉन्डिंग है. आप अगर मम्मी आपकी बाहर चली जाती है तो आपको याद आती है मम्मी की, पापा चले जाते हैं तो पापा की याद आती है. क्यों? क्योंकि आपको उनके साथ बॉन्डिंग है. करेक्ट. अभी थोड़े दिनों के बाद जब आप बड़े हो जाएंगे, आपका जॉब लग जाएगा, आपकी शादी हो जाएगी, आपके बच्चे हो जाएंगे, तो फिर आपका बॉन्डिंग अपने बच्चों के साथ ज्यादा हो जाएगा. पर आपके बॉन्डिंग अपने मम्मी पापा के साथ इतना स्ट्रांग नहीं रहेगा. रहना चाहिए स्ट्रांग, लेकिन उतना स्ट्रांग नहीं रहेगा. करेक्ट. क्योंकि आजकल का ट्रेडिशन आप देख ही रहे, मम्मी पापा को सब बुढ़ापे में भूल जाते हैं. बहुत 1% कैसे जैसे हैं जो अपने मम्मी पापा को याद रखते हैं, अपने मिसेस के साथ, अपने बच्चों के साथ. तो क्या होता है, ये सिंपल रूल है. क्या है कि नया बॉन्ड बनता है, पुराना बॉन्ड टूटता है. तो ये बॉन्ड टूट गया, इससे क्या हुआ नेक्स्ट? अब ऐसा बनने से क्या हुआ, ये जो बॉन्डिंग थी, ये अभी देखो ये वाला बॉन्ड इस साइड में है. करेक्ट. इस डायरेक्शन में. ड्यू टू कमिंग दिस न्यू बॉन्ड, दिस बॉन्ड कॉन्फिगरेशन स्टार्ट, द कॉन्फिगरेशन गेट इन्वर्टेड. तो ये इस तरीके से जाता है. ये बॉन्ड बन गया. अब तो इलेक्ट्रॉन इसने दे दिया, इसलिए नाउ अब हम ऐसा नहीं शो करेंगे इलेक्ट्रॉन, क्योंकि इलेक्ट्रॉन इसने इसको दे दिया. ये न्यूक्लियोफाइल हो गया और ये बॉन्ड इधर चले गए. अब देखो, वी कैन शो दिस, व्हाट एवर आई हैव ड्रॉ दिस, दिस फुल प्रोसेस यू कैन शो लाइक दिस, वेरी सिंपल वे. CH3Cl plus, we can take any nucleophile, Nu, then CH3, Nu, plus Cl minus. You can simply show. But I have shown like this, because this is a mechanism. Correct? This is mechanism. So in simple way, you can show this reaction. If you take in place of a nucleophile, you take an example of nucleophile, let it be hydroxide, OH ion. Then what happens? Here will be OH ion. Correct? Here will be OH ion. Hydroxide ion is a nucleophile. So this is now alcohol. Correct? Nucleophilic substitution reaction. Now what are the example of nucleophilic substitution reaction? Say one nucleophile OH, then product is alcohol. Another nucleophile, if suppose we take alkoxide ion. Nucleophile, in your book there is a table and there are so many nucleophile, and this is very important direction for board examination point of view. So you have to learn the example of nucleophile. I am giving you the example like OR, okay, na? OR, alkoxidine. And now which species will give OR? NaOR. Sodium alkoxide. This is the reagent. Sodium alkoxide. NaOR. Sodium alkoxide, from sodium alkoxide reagent we get alkoxide ion. Correct. So when we use this alkoxide ion as a nucleophile, then this alkoxide ion substitute chlorine and the product will be OR. Product will be OR. Product will be OR. Correct. Now in place of this, if suppose we take another nucleophile, अब जनरल ले लेते हैं, आर एक्स कर लेते हैं, आर एक्स। सपोज बीटा एक NH3 न्यूक्लियोफाइल, NH3 न्यूक्लियोफाइल, एंड व्हाट इज द प्रोडक्ट? NH3 इज अ न्यूक्लियोफाइल, जस्ट नाउ आई टोल्ड यू लुईस बेस, लुईस बेस आर न्यूक्लियोफाइल, लुईस बेस आर न्यूक्लियोफाइल, सो NH3 इज अ न्यूक्लियोफाइल। When it attack over here, halogen get substituted, then the product will be R NH2 plus HX, correct? So R NH2 is amines, the product is amine. अभी देखा आपने, alcohol भी बना, now amine भी बन गया, उससे पहले NaOR लिया था तो ether बना था, correct? Now I will ask the question from you. Suppose in place of NH3, you take KCN. What will the product? Astha Dwivedi speak. If we take KCN as a reagent, then this KCN reagent will provide which nucleophile? Astha, Aditi, anyone of you tell, speak. Anjali, anyone speak? If you know the answer from KCN, which nucleophile we can get?
CN.
CN, correct. Very good. CN. CN nucleophile aega. So X will be substituted by CN. RCN, correct? Then this is KX. Sorry, KX, correct? Now, here is a very interesting thing. If we take KCN, then main product is RCN. If we take RX plus AgCN, then this RNC, main product is RNC plus AgX. So this is a very, very important question that has been asked in the board examination. If we do the reaction of haloalkane with KCN, the main product is alkyl cyanide. If we take silver cyanide in place of potassium cyanide, the main product is isocyanide. Why? But समझ आई बात नहीं आई? You understand the question? Aman Ghazi Khan, Bhavna Ameta, you understand the question or not? Some students are not giving any response. Why? This Google Meet class means you have to give response. Now I will explain you. Namrata Bunkar, can you know why it is so? Anyone of you? Gracie Sharma, question samajh mein aaya? Answer aa sakta hai aapke dimag mein? देखिए, आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू व्हाई इट इज सो, बिकॉज केसीएन इज आयनिक कंपाउंड एंड एजीसीएन इज कोवेलेंट कंपाउंड, प्रीडोमिनेंटली कोवेलेंट, मतलब स्लाइटली आयनिक है, स्लाइटली कोवेलेंट है, सो इसका नेचर कोवेलेंट ज्यादा है. इफ यू कंपेयर द नेचर, देन सिल्वर साइनाइड इज कोवेलेंट इन नेचर, इट बिहेव एज अ कोवेलेंट कंपाउंड, एंड केसीएन इज प्योर आयनिक कंपाउंड. When it is pure ionic compound, then ionic compound furnish ions. So it will give potassium ion and cyanide ion. Now, silver cyanide, because it is a covalent compound, so it will undergo homolytic fission and it will produce silver free radical and cyanide free radical. It will produce free radical. It will produce ion. So what is the difference between CN minus and CN dot? This is ion, this is free radical. CN minus means it has one extra electron. And if you see the structure of CN, because it is negatively charged, so over the carbon and over the nitrogen, both species had one extra electron. Her species per extra electron, one pair electron hoga. नाइट्रोजन पर भी होगा, कार्बन पर भी, क्योंकि इट गेट वन एक्स्ट्रा इलेक्ट्रॉन. सो बिकॉज दिस साइनाइड आयन इज कैपेबल टू अटैक और गिव इलेक्ट्रॉन, डोनेट इलेक्ट्रॉन थ्रू नाइट्रोजन और थ्रू कार्बन. इट कैन अटैक द कार्बन एटम, दिस पार्शियल पॉजिटिव चार्ज कार्बन एटम है, इसको ये कार्बन भी इलेक्ट्रॉन देकर अटैक कर सकता है. मतलब ये अगर ये आएगा इधर, सपोज सी एन माइनस है, तो सी एन माइनस आ रहा है, तो सी ट्रिपल बॉन्ड एन, एन पर भी इलेक्ट्रॉन है, क्लोरीन पे, तो ये क्लोरीन अपने जो इलेक्ट्रॉन है ये इसको दे देगा, क्योंकि इस कार्बन पर पॉजिटिव चार्ज है. करेक्ट. अब क्वेश्चन ये, व्हाई नाइट्रोजन डू नॉट गिव इलेक्ट्रॉन दिस? बिकॉज कार्बन कार्बन बॉन्ड इज मोर स्टेबल देन कार्बन नाइट्रोजन बॉन्ड. कार्बन कार्बन बॉन्ड इज मोर स्टेबल, मोर स्ट्रॉन्ग बॉन्ड. दैट्स व्हाई आपने पढ़ा होगा 9th या 10th क्लास में, व्हाई कार्बन कंपाउंड और सो लार्ज इन नंबर. एक उसमें एक उसका इफेक्ट था ड्यू टू कैटिनेशन. कैटिनेशन क्या होता है? सेल्फ लिंकिंग प्रॉपर्टी. कार्बन है सेल्फ लिंकिंग प्रॉपर्टी, मींस कार्बन फॉर्म लार्ज नंबर ऑफ बॉन्ड बिटवीन देमसेल्फ एंड इट फॉर्म अ लॉन्ग चेन. करेक्ट. सो कार्बन कार्बन बॉन्ड, दैट्स व्हाई, बिकॉज इट कैन गिव इलेक्ट्रॉन आइदर थ्रू कार्बन आइदर थ्रू नाइट्रोजन, बट कार्बन कार्बन बॉन्ड इज मोर स्टेबल, दैट्स व्हाई इट प्रेफर टू डोनेट द इलेक्ट्रॉन थ्रू कार्बन. दैट्स व्हाई आइस कार्बो साइनाइड विल फॉर्म, एल्किल साइनाइड विल फॉर्म. नाउ इन दिस केस इफ यू सी द साइनाइड फ्री रेडिकल, तो इनके साथ साइनाइड फ्री रेडिकल, देयर इज ओनली वन इलेक्ट्रॉन हियर ऑन द कार्बन, सो कार्बन कैन नॉट डोनेट इलेक्ट्रॉन, ओनली नाइट्रोजन कैन डोनेट इलेक्ट्रॉन. Nitrogen can donate electron. That's why it can all, it has only one option to give to form bond through nitrogen. That's why in case of silver cyanide, it form isocyanide. Correct? Another very interesting thing. If you do the reaction between KNO2, then it form RNO2. And if you go reaction with silver AgNO2, then product will be, sorry, RONO or ye RNO2. Matlab kehne ka ye ki if a compound a reagent is partially positive covalent in nature, then alkyl group only form bond through nitrogen. Ab what is the difference between these two? अब क्वेश्चन बना सकते हैं बोर्ड एग्जाम में, हेलो एल्केन ऑन रिएक्शन विद पोटेशियम नाइट्राइट द प्रोडक्ट इज एल्किल नाइट्राइट, ठीक है ना, बट सिल्वर नाइट्राइट के नाइट्रो, नाइट्राइट नहीं नाइट्रो है, इसका नाम क्या, नाइट्रो एल्केन, ये एल्किल नाइट्राइट है, दो अलग डिफरेंट कंपाउंड है. बिकॉज नाइट्रो एल्केन में बॉन्डिंग थ्रू नाइट्रोजन, नाइट्राइट में बॉन्डिंग थ्रू ऑक्सीजन. करेक्ट. So why it is so? Because the same explanation. KNO2 is the ionic compound. So it will give NO2 ion. In NO2 ion, it can both over oxygen atom and nitrogen atom, there is a facility to donate electron and attack through oxygen and nitrogen if both are equal. So, but carbon oxygen bond is more strong. That's why it prefers to form bond through oxygen. In case of silver nitride, it will produce free radical. So only nitrogen has electron pair. That's why it formed bond through nitrogen. So student, any doubt in this? This is very, very important question for a board examination point of view. I hope this type of question so many times will ask, and this year also you may get this question in your exam. So you go through this. So now you tell, all of you understand this concept? Speak loudly, Charu Suvalka, Charu Barma. No doubt, sir. Yes, very good. Udita Soni, yes, sir. You understand, na? This question? Correct. Instead of writing.
Yes, sir.
हाँ ऐसे.
Yes, sir.
बोला करो. लिखने से.
Yes, sir.
हाँ बोलने
से. Yes, sir. Got it, sir.
Yes, sir.
Understand this concept, na? Now yes, I will go to the yes, next sir. Concept, mechanism of nucleophilic substitution reaction, before I proceed to the nucleophilic substitution reaction mechanism, I will give you an assignment. And tomorrow I will see you. You can show your assignment. You do your own copy, or you send the photocopy to my WhatsApp number. At least you have to write 15 nucleophilic substitution reaction with different nucleophilic agent. Different agent which provide nucleophile. Correct? It is given in your book, but you have to write the reaction. So you have to do practice. So student, for tomorrow, I will explain you mechanism of nucleophilic substitution reaction. Understand? So now, if you have any doubt, you can ask. I will give you 1 minute. Otherwise, you leave the class so that I can wind up the class. If you have any doubt, you can ask. No doubt, Achcha.
No.
If you have any doubt, you can speak. Instead of writing, you speak. Correct? Vivek Pachauri? Otherwise, if you do not have any doubt, you leave the class so that I can also wind up. Okay, student? Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, ab wind up karne ke liye.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, student, welcome again. Karte ho. Ek minute ho gaya. So leave the class slowly. First you will leave, then I will wind up. Okay.